Hey, it's Mishlawi. Subscribe to D Blake Worldwide on YouTube.
Right now, music worldwide, post88.co.uk. I'm in Islandrecords right now, in the boardroom, you know, very special. And I'm here with a worldwide artist, goes by the name of Mishlawi. How are you doing, bro?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Pleasure to meet you,
Pleasure
man.
Pleasure to meet you too, man.
Jeez. Yeah, it's good, man. So we got our waters, I got my coffee, we're feeling good, feeling refreshed.
Yeah, drink more water.
That's it. Yeah, a liter in a day at least. So I'll try to anyway. Yeah. But how's your journey in, man? How's it been?
Good, man, good. Yeah. I came in yesterday, actually, and we're doing promo today and tomorrow, doing some interviews and stuff, and that's it, man. Mm-hmm. It's always good to come back to London.
Okay, that's what's up. You know, making it from the start of your journey, you know, to Island Records, I want you to take us through the process, you know, of how that journey has come.
Yeah, man, well, I started making music when I was like, I did music forever, like, for my whole life, pretty much, but in different ways. Like, in the beginning, I played instruments more. So I played a little bit of drums. My dad played guitar, so he taught me some things. I played electric bass for a little bit. And only when I was 15, I'm 21 now, only when I was 15 did I decide, yeah, I want to write songs.
Yeah.
And so I started rapping, because I didn't really sing like that.
Yeah.
But so I started writing raps and whatever, recording them, but just for fun. I didn't really have any ambitions of like taking it seriously to a career level or anything like that. But it wasn't until a couple years after in Portugal, where I was living, that I met another artist who was pretty popular at the time. His name is Richie Campbell, who is a good friend of mine now. Exactly.
Yeah.
Me and him met, and I showed him some of my music, thinking like, I want to see what this guy thinks, but also probably he won't answer. He's probably too busy or this and that, like the obvious things to think. And so me and him actually just became friends, and he started to like my music, and not long after that, I signed with his management and bookings agency. Yeah, and it wasn't too long after that that I started to release my own songs through the agency independently, but just with their help, and they kind of lent me some money in the beginning to make my first music videos, buy beats, work with producers, and use their connections and stuff. And it was 2 years after that, last year in 2017, that I signed with Universal Music Germany, and I also got the opportunity with Island through that.
Wow. So tell us about some of those early musical influences that inspired the sound, you know?
Yeah, I would say when I started rapping, hip-hop wise, like the music that I listened to that made me want to really pursue rap music was one of the main ones was J. Cole. Like, I really like J. Cole's music. Ever since the beginning of the stuff that he would put out, like Friday Night Lights, the warm up, like his mixtape times, I was really inspired by what he did, just the way that he painted pictures through his raps and stuff like that. So I really got into hip hop music through him. And yeah, man, after that, like, I started to get more into R&B music as well, and the whole melodic side of more like melodic music, more R&B, more soul music, stuff like that. Even dancehall and some reggae music because of my friend Richie and in the circle of friends that he hung around with.
And you know, you're owning a bit about your heritage as well. Tell us your background, you know, exactly where you're from in Portugal. Let them know a bit about the area you're from.
Yeah, well, I actually grew up in the States. I grew up in the US. Yeah, I grew up in Phoenix, Arizona. But I moved to Portugal when I was 10 because of my dad's work. So I lived the most significant part of my life in Portugal. That's where I met like most of my friends that I hang out with still today. Like most of the influences of my life I got there. But yeah, Lisbon, Portugal, the capital. And but yeah, man, my dad is actually Lebanese and my mom is Turkish.
Okay.
So I'm kind of like, it's a confusing story, you know, but it's just like the way that everybody immigrated to the States, my parents did.
Yeah.
They met there and then I was born there, yeah.
That's truly worldwide feel.
Yeah, exactly, man, yeah.
Speaking of worldwide, you know, artists always give me a thing we call the language check.
Okay.
So, you know, it's where you teach me a line from Portugal, you know, your country, that I can, on something that I can say when I go, you know, to Portugal.
Okay, myself. Well, let's start with something basic. How about?
And you got gravy, you know, if I pass it A, B, or C, or a D.
All right.
Be honest as well.
Let's start with something pretty easy because Portuguese has a pretty complicated pronunciation.
Yeah.
So
okay, I'm ready.
All right. How about hello? How are you? All right. So in Portuguese, hello, how are you is olá, tudo bem.
Olá, tudo bem.
Olá, tudo bem.
Olá, tudo bem.
That's pretty good.
Okay. Okay, okay. You got A, B, or C or
that? I'd say that's like a B.
B, okay.
It's pretty good. That's a B. That's
Hola,
good.
Tobin.
Hola, Tobin.
Hola, Tobin.
Yeah, he's got the... he's got the nasal thing going on.
You're teaching me, man.
Yeah, you got it.
You're learning from the best right now. Give me one more. Give me something I can say to if I see. You know, I'm walking down to the beach and I see, you know, I don't know, see a pretty lady or something. What can I say, you know?
Yeah, all right. So if you want to say, like, what's your name?
Yeah.
You say, como é que te chamas?
Oh, you got me here now.
All right, hold on. I'm going to break it down for you, all right? Como?
Yeah, como.
É?
Como é?
Que?
Como é que?
Que?
Como é que?
Te?
Te?
Chamas.
Chamas.
Now you gotta put it all together. Wow. Alright, you ready? Hold on. Como é que chamas?
Como é que chamas?
That's pretty good. That was a little bit, I would say that was like a B.
Nah, he was dead in it.
That could be a B minus.
Alright, I'll take that. So, you know, we done the language check right there. So now when I go to Portugal, I'm ready, I'm loaded up, I've got a couple words, so I'm blessed. Yeah, man, so that's the language check right there. So, is Drake your brother?
Is Drake my brother?
Yeah, because you look alike. Have you heard this before?
I think Drake might be like my uncle's cousin's brother's roommate's daughter's, my sister's brother.
Okay, so there's no like relationship. You got a distance. That's what I'm saying. Maybe you got to check like one of those kind of, I don't know, heritage check.
Really. Nah, bro, it's just a beard, bro.
Okay, just a beard guy.
Yeah, I think if I shave my beard, you probably wouldn't think I look like Drake that much.
Have you heard it before though?
I maybe heard it like once or twice.
Okay, cool. What do you find a Drake?
I know
you got the melodic style.
Yeah, I like Drake's music, definitely. Okay. Drake is definitely a huge influence for every artist nowadays.
Okay. Yeah, man. So how did you singing and rapping, man, it's something I feel that's happening more nowadays.
Yeah.
So why do you think that is, man? Because before, I think back in the day, it wasn't so significant. You know, it was more, you know, you sing.
One or the other.
Rap, yeah, kind of thing.
Well, I think maybe for one it has to do with how competitive the music industry is. For you to be competitive in the industry nowadays, you need to be able to be versatile.
Yeah.
I think for you to have like a long career, you need to be able to do more than one thing. Mm-hmm. Back in the day, you had only rappers or only singers. You still have both.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I feel like the more versatile you can be and the more types of music you can pursue, the better it will be for you in the long run in the industry. So, but for my case, it was just like, that's the music that I like. I like hip hop music, I like to rap, and I like to sing. And singing was actually something that came later to me just because the people around me showed me different types of music. So I got into it more and I thought, hey, maybe someday I could try this out as well. And I did, and I liked it, so I continued to do it. I was from the city, she was from the outside, I was from the north, she was from the south side. I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night. Cause I was from the city, she was from the outside, I was from the north, she was from the south side. I looked in the mirror, I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night. Rappers sound like Dr. Seuss, but not as dope. Clench your teeth and bite my flow. These focus bogus, y'all go home. Therapist said I should focus. I had reached the lowest lows. Hurt my psyche, I should notice. Do you care? You probably don't. Confidence had lowered to a degree I thought would never show. Yeah, what you got a couple months to get my act together. And you know, you got a great big single right now, All Night. A track that I'm loving. I love the record,
but I want you to tell us about it first. Just tell us about the record.
Yeah. So the record, it had, for the first time when I heard the beat, is right away I knew that I wanted to jump on it, because it has something that I thought was really fresh and something that I heard for the first time, which was the whole Latin sample mixed with the trap drums, you know? So right away I knew, like, hey, this is something that people haven't really heard before, and I wanna see what I can do with it. And I had a chorus that I actually wrote on another beat before, which was the All Night chorus, but I hadn't recorded anything nor put it out. So when I heard the All Night beat, I tried to apply it there. I was just vibing over it, and I was like, hey, this actually fits pretty well. So I put that on there, And then I recorded two rap verses really quickly. I probably finished the song in like two or three hours. It was the fastest song I ever made because I was just so like inspired and feeling it. Yeah, the vibe. But I didn't expect. I just recorded it like with a bad microphone at my house, just chilling. Like, I didn't really take it too seriously when I first made it. But yeah, man, it's just one of those things that you don't expect it to turn out the way that they do, and everything went pretty well, so it's good.
Did you, when you was in the studio creating the record, did you write lyrics, or did you just jump in and just literally freestyle the record?
I wrote them, but it came quickly. Yeah. Like, wow. It was just something that I was just like, it was just a vibe. I didn't even want to try to think too much into it or try to write something too conceptual. I was just trying to be like, just turn up and have fun with it, you know? It was just one of those things.
Man, those lit vibes, man. And you know, the sample, that's what stood out for me when I first heard the record. Like, I just, it's like the horns and it felt like a trumpet kind of thing.
Yeah.
The real kind of just a flagship part of the song. Just tell us a bit about that sample, man, because I feel that sample is really engaging, man.
Yeah.
Really creates the mood and the vibe from the start.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the sample is actually was composed by Chick Corea. Who is like a legendary composer and Latin jazz pianist, exactly. Cool. And he wrote that, but he actually, the piece that I sampled, he composed it, but he actually didn't perform it. So after he wrote it, the one who performed it, there were a few of them actually, but Willie Bobo
was the artist
who actually performed and recorded it. So that was the one that we had sampled originally. But yeah, man, the sample I just thought was crazy as well, and the way that it looped, it was so like bouncy and so feel good vibes. So that's it, man.
Proper feel good vibes, man. I've had that one on in the gym, all sorts. That's actually gonna be my, when I go on holiday soon, that's gonna be one of my anthems on holiday, man.
Cool, man, I hope so.
Yeah, Gran Canary, soon see ya. But I was gonna say, so regarding the record, tell us about that mask in the video.
Yeah. Oh,
you reminded me of the WWE wrestler.
Actually, that was my manager who did that. So the video was like the lowest budget video ever. It was actually, a lot of people think that it was filmed in a club. It looks like a club, right?
And the special effects and.
But it's in a bedroom. Wow. Actually, the place that I'm sitting is on a bed. Yeah. But a lot of people don't understand that, just because there's so much like color to it and stuff, smoke and whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'll get to the mask in 1 second, but. It was an extremely low budget video. We filmed it in my manager's bedroom at his house.
Okay.
We didn't want to spend too much money on the video, so we thought we would do something just like cool visually. Yeah. So we just hooked it up with like a lot of lights, smoke machine, and just like did something freaky looking with the editing and stuff. So basically the song chorus was, I was from the city, she was from the outside, I was from the north, south side, little did I know I'd be crying all night. And basically the video concept was kind of like something freaky about, and it would show me, and then it would show a guy in the background with a girl, and then it would show that guy with the mask, and basically the guy with the mask is supposed to be like a psychopath, like going crazy. Okay. It was basically like it was going crazy with the emotions that the girl was making him feel, type of thing.
Yeah, it's like it felt like there was like faded shots as well. Yeah. It's like I would see one shot coming in, I'm looking deeply, and I could see another shot like underneath kind of thing.
Yeah, it was supposed to be like really freaky looking.
Yeah, it's real lame. You've done a good job, man.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Yeah, man. It's 8 million views on YouTube, right?
Yeah.
How are you feeling about those kind of numbers out there, man?
It's great, man. Yeah. It's a blessing. But obviously, it's still time to take the next step and learn what I've learned from that.
Yeah.
And put more music out and just try to create a catalog, because I'm still in the beginning of my career, so.
Okay, it's a big track that's doing well for you out here. What's your expectations for the record out here? Is it like, are you releasing it in the charts out here? What's going on with it out here? Is it, you know, is it already out-wise, you know?
So we're releasing it, the label's releasing it again, and we're gonna have some help with like, because we finally got it on Spotify.
Great, congratulations.
Thank you, man, it took a while to get it on Spotify, so. Yeah, we're trying to get on some Spotify playlists, some radio stations, whatever we can, and hopefully we'll be able to create a little bit of some bubbles out here and maybe do some shows pretty soon. That would be great.
Definitely. Well, you know, we've been added to the Post 88 A-list and our A-list, so we put that straight to the top.
That's amazing. Place, thank you, man. I appreciate it.
No worries, bro. It's a big record. So, you know, we talked about the expectations. What are you working on after this record right now, man? When this kind of dies down, what you got kind of the EP?
Yeah, so we're thinking about releasing an EP with some songs that I already have out to reach the audiences that haven't been able to hear them yet. But for the most part, as far as new music goes, we want to release my debut project this year with like a bunch of new music that I created this year.
Oh, that's brilliant, man. Do you have a title for your debut project at the moment?
I do not yet.
Okay, cool.
But hopefully it will be released sometime this year, probably after the summer.
Okay, cool. Let's talk UK artists, man. Are you aware of our scene out here in the UK, and who you feeling, any names?
There's a few, man. There's a bunch, actually, but one that I've been mentioning a lot because of just a guy that I've been hearing a bunch, and I really like his music, is J-Hus. J-Hus is great, man. I really like his music. I think he's funny. I think he has personality. Like, he's a great artist.
Yeah, man. He's got bangers, man. Anyone else that comes to mind?
I would say I like Krept and Konan a lot too.
Okay.
Just because I like that like hard, aggressive like trap and hip hop as well. So I think they're dope. Also, I like Stefflon Don. I like Nate Smalls.
Nate Smalls also.
It's just like a great market, like, and nowadays a lot of good artists are coming out independently as well, and like showing great like just making great music nowadays. So I really like the British market, man.
There's a question I ask here where it's a new kind of question, but I've changed it a little bit. It's the top three worldwide artists that you want to collab with. I'm talking around the world, though. Different countries. Three different countries, yeah. But what I want you to do now is use your name to pick a country, the capital letter of the country in your name.
Okay.
And then, so let's do that first. So pick three countries that are spelled in your name, first letter.
With
the
N?
No, just any, all the words in your name, just three countries, the first letter of the country.
All the letters in my name?
Yeah, you can pick, for instance, you can pick, I don't know, like, let me see, you can pick.
So M-I-S-H.
M for Malta.
Damn.
Yeah. L for Lithuania. And then another country. Let's pick three. I know it's a brainstormer.
All right, it's gonna be a hard one. Damn, countries that start with M.
No, M. It could be M I S H A W I. That's how it's spelled your name.
All right. Yeah.
Anyone. There's three countries.
Still, these letters.
Yeah, these are not easy letters at all.
I done my whole name the other day, like.
You did?
Yeah, I did. You know. Dan Blake, but I done Daniel Blake is my full name.
You got more options.
I done, yeah.
All right, let me see.
I hope you won, like, multiple. But then think deeply, because then when you pick the letters, you got to think of an artist from that country that you work with. Yeah, so that's why it's deep, part. You know, it's deep. It's nice.
There's actually nothing, like, obvious in his name.
Okay. So is it too hard? You got to pass on that one.
It might be.
Can you give us one?
All right.
Yeah, give you one. Yeah, we'll do one. Three may be hard. Just one. So one artist, one country. You know, any letter in your name.
I for Italy.
Okay, perfect. We've got Italy now. Yeah. So, is there an artist from Italy that you may want to work with? Or like, or
loose
like,
tight
please.
In Italy, yeah.
The deep pressure in it, yeah.
Man, what's his name? Yeah, what's his name?
What's the name of the song?
What's the guy who has the song, the guy who's kind of, who's Italian but looks kind of Arab, you know who I'm talking about? I think he has dreadlocks, he has a song called Habibi. Search it up.
I'm talking about this, the one that I was singing, you don't know
who. Pick up Habibi.
Oh yeah, that one too.
What's his name?
I can't remember. Italy's a hard one, yeah. Man. I have, damn. You got me on the spot.
Yeah, no worries, man. You tried, man. You tried.
Bro, if I search for Habibi,
it's gonna be 3 million.
3 million
topics.
You know, and you know, you linked up. You know, the reggae artist that you linked up with from your country, from Portugal.
Yeah, Richie. Yeah.
Richie. He's real talented, man.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Tell us about your relationship and how you guys, you know, met up and stuff. How did you connect, man?
So actually, the story is funny, man. It's It was in 2014. I was like 17 at the time.
Yeah.
And me and my friends were at the mall, walking around the mall. And a girl who was in our group at that day, she was actually on The Voice Portugal.
Oh, The Voice Portugal.
She was killing it. She had a really nice voice and she was doing a good job. Yeah. And I remember we bumped into Richie. He was walking around the mall as well. And Richie actually came up to us because he asked my friend to take a picture with her. Oh. And we were like super hyped for her because Richie was very popular at the time. He had a big hit in Portugal. And so after that, my friends were telling me like, yo, you should talk to Richie too and show him your music. And I was kind of like, he doesn't want to hear that. You know, he hears that all the time. And they were like, no, you really got to. And so I was just, eventually I was just like, all right, fine, I'll do it. So I went and talked to him. And basically he just gave me his email. And I emailed him like some of my songs, but I was thinking like, he'll probably not answer.
Yeah, you know them ones that, when you think, ah, they're not going to answer.
Yeah, they're too busy. Yeah. They got a lot of shit to do. But it actually, a couple days after that, he answered me. And we just started to like talk more and more. I would update him on my music. He would show me his stuff. Yeah. And I think it was like a year after that, he told me that he wanted to work with me. And then I signed to the same management and bookings agency as him. And ever since then, we've been really good friends. He moved to a house not far from mine.
You hang out and chill.
So we link all the time.
A couple of drinks. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Definitely. And we have a song together that did pretty well in Portugal as well. Yeah. And that's going to be one of the songs on the EP that we'll release.
Okay, man. You want to let the people know the song?
Yeah, the song is called Boo Hoo. That song was actually one that it was like my two. It was. When did it come out? It actually came out in 2016 as well. I think it was around March or April, but I'm not exactly sure. And that was the first time me and Richie linked up in the studio and said like, let's try to create something. And it was actually way out of his sound. He was kind of adapting more to my sound because he was doing reggae at the time. And it was just fun, man. We were just catching a vibe and it happened to turn out like into something that we both thought was dope. And luckily a lot of people in Portugal thought so as well. And we performed it several times together and it's just chill. It's cool to have. To be as close friends as we are and share some created art together, so it's dope, man.
That's amazing, and it's always good to know that, you know, apart from yourselves, what other artists in Portugal you're working with or who's, you know, doing good stuff in Portugal right now. Who would you recommend out there?
Out in Portugal?
Yeah.
The thing is with Portuguese music, we're in Portugal, me and Richie are the only two artists that make music in English, but there definitely is cool music in Portuguese. But,
would you do something? Have you done music in Portuguese?
I've never done music in Portuguese.
Oh, was something you would do in the future?
I'm actually not sure. I would think probably not. Just because I feel more comfortable speaking English because it's actually my first language. But I do like Portuguese music a lot, and if I were to recommend music, man, I would say for the people who don't know Portuguese music, probably start from the source and probably start from like traditional Portuguese music.
Yeah, so what kind of stuff is that like?
So if you ever heard of Amália Rodrigues?
Never.
Amália Rodrigues.
Okay.
She's the She's one of the pioneers and most popular artists of traditional Portuguese music called Fado. Yeah, and Fado is actually, it's a very beautiful type of music. It's like, it's kind of a, it's sad music, but the style of singing is just something that's very unique in itself, I think, and I think it's definitely something that people who don't know Portuguese music should check out. Also, the Portuguese guitar has a very unique sound as well, and it's also used a lot in that type of music. It's dope, man. It's great.
That's amazing, man. And I need you to give me that local check. So, for instance, if I'm local in Portugal, where do I stay and what should I do? One thing I should do.
Anywhere in Portugal or places you should go?
Anywhere. Just one place where I should check in and one thing I should do.
Okay.
There was one suggestion, a place and something I could do. What would you suggest?
Man, if you go to Portugal, you should go to the Algarve, the south of Portugal, which is a very popular place that people go to in the summer. Actually, I was mentioning to you before, a lot of British people go there during the summertime. It's great, man, to go to the beach.
Yeah.
The water is warm.
That's
the women are beautiful. The people are nice, and there's a lot of British people too, so you could actually find a lot of people who speak your language.
Well, I appreciate that, man. See, I need those checks, man. When I come through, I'll be like, yeah. Mishlawi, show me what's good.
You'll be safe.
That's it. Give us a fun story you've had in your music career, man. Your funniest moment so far. If it can be said on camera, but you know.
Yeah, damn, definitely.
Give us a PG version, if anything.
Funny things, like any type of funny thing.
Yeah, just I always ask for a memory that stuck with you so far in your journey. That's a fun time where you're just having great fun, man. Energy was like, wow, this is life, man. I'm enjoying my life right now.
Yeah.
Enjoying this moment. You know, what was that? You know, that you share with us.
Man, so I guess overall, like, not speaking about it in one specific time, but the most fun times to me, I believe, in music and throughout my career so far has been performing. Because I never really been, I don't have too much experience on stage because I've always been working in the studio.
Yeah, for real. Yeah.
But when I started to perform for the first time, it was like a whole different world to me. It's way different than the studio.
Yeah, different.
And nowadays, when I perform with a band, and my band are actually my friends. The people that So I have a band it's me, it's a DJ, a guitar, a keyboard, and a drummer. Wow. It's a pretty small band, 3-piece and a DJ as well. And the cool thing about when we tour and we do shows together is that they're all young. They're all around 20, 21, 22 years old. And it's just like, it's a fun experience.
Yeah.
We go places we've never been before, we drink, we party after the show, and we perform together and have a great time. Yeah.
That's what's up, man. Great memory there. Give out your social media, man, so that people can, keep in touch.
Definitely. On Instagram, it's just Mishlawi. Mm. On Twitter, it's Mishlawi. Mm. And on Facebook, it's also Mishlawi. I don't use Facebook too much, but I try to. I try to keep it updated.
Your Facebook live there and there.
Yeah, but
give us a wisdom quote as well. What quote do you live by? You're like, this is my energy. This is what kind of defines me.
Yeah, I would say, man, hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard. That's a classic one.
It's a classic.
Yeah, that's a classic one. I like that one a lot. That's something that I live by.
Jeez. Yo, Mishlawi, man, it's been a pleasure.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Love, brother.
Thank you. All right, guys. Jeez.
Teeth and bite my flow, these focus bogus, y'all go home. therapist said I should focus. I had reached the lowest lows. Hurt my psyche, I should notice. Do you care? You probably don't. Confidence had lowered to a degree I thought would never show.
Yeah, what you got?
Got a couple months to get my act together. Get the shit up off my shoulders. I swear it's a heavy load.
She was from the outside, I was from the north. She was from the south side, I looked in the mirror. I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night. Cause I was from the city. She was from the outside, I was from the north. She was from the south side, I looked in the mirror. I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night. Cause I was from the city.
100 man, me time, we tired of counting them hundreds. Ain't no opponent now, where is the fun at? No competition, the game, what we own at? I've been to places and I'm in the zone at 351, I've been waiting for dope rap, and I'm here now. Yeah, I've been killing shit since 96. Make legend rappers my sidekicks. Tell record labels no mind tricks. I got cosigns, a whole line of it. Let's get it.
She was from the outside, I was from the north. She was from the south side, I looked in the mirror. I said, man, I'm alright. I'd be crying all night, cause I was from the city. She was from the outside, I was from the north. She was from the south side, I looked in the mirror. I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night, cause I was from the city. She was from the outside, I was from the north. She was from the south side, I looked in the mirror. I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night, cause I was from the city. She was from the outside, I was from the north. She was from the south side, I looked in the mirror. I said, man, I'm alright. Little did I know I'd be crying all night.